Hello friends, welcome back. After long days, I'm again coming back. Okay, today we're going to talk about hypermedia as the engine of application store. We have completed most of the things in the web service part in Spring Boot. Now we're going Spring Boot, right? Part of Spring Boot, we have done so many examples, the RESTful web services. There are two concepts I need to take. One is the Hetios. Another one is richness and maturity model. This is the only concept. This does not have any programming, but hypermedia as the engine of application state, that is called as Hetios. Hetios is a concept that we can implement in RESTful web services. What is hypermedia as the engine of application state? For example, let's say I am going to my Facebook app. Here, there are some posts, right? For example, let's take some post. Yeah. If you look at this Facebook post, there is, well, while displaying this particular post, we are showing some other resource also. It's a like and comments, some additional links. Whatever related link to this post, and this particular page bringing related to the content. For example, like is related to this particular post, comment it is related to this particular post. So this is called as Hetios. Whenever you bring some resource, in addition, I want to bring some related to that resource. That concept is called as a Hetios. For example, when I view the user, in our example, we're going to see when you the user, I want to show one more link, view all user. One more link for view all user. This view all user should generate automatically by Hetios framework. Okay, we don't have to explicitly do some program to construct the view all users. That done by automatically the concept of hypermedia as the engine of application state. Okay, now it's going to see how to implement that. Okay, in our user controller class, we have already one method called user id endpoint, that is api user slash user id that will return a particular user. Now I want to implement whenever return a user id, whenever view particular user, I want to generate view all user link. That is, this is the endpoint get all user. This get all user return all the user from the database. What is this endpoint here? This endpoint is api slash users. That's it. We say api slash users with get mapping. This method get invoke and return list of user from the database. Okay, whenever call this particular method, particular endpoint, I want to view that user. Along with that user information, I want to add one more information, that is a one link. That link will return all the user. That link, what is that link? This is the endpoint, that link. Okay, for example, whenever view the user, I want to generate the link which return all the user. Okay, I want to generate this link. api slash users, I want to generate these links. Whenever view particular user id, I want to generate this particular link to view all the users. Okay, let's see how to do that. I don't want to disturb this method. I am going to create a separate method. That endpoint is users hetios slash user id as a path variable. Whenever call this particular endpoint, I want to generate link for get all users. Okay, let's see how to do that. If you want to implement this particular Hetios concept, we need to add a one starter project called springboard starter head use. Springboard starter head use. We need to add this artifact. Okay, this artifact provides provide some API. Using that API, we can generate the related links for a particular resource. In our case, what is a resource? User is our resource. When we view the particular user resource, I want to view, I want to get the link for, I want to get the link for to view all the users. That is our intention. Okay. Now here, I am getting the user ID here. I am passing the user ID here. Using this get method, get user by ID, I am getting user information. Okay. Now I am adding this user information in an entity model. This entity model is coming from Etios API, Etios framework. This entity model, I am initializing user using the user object. Okay. Now, meaning of this line is I am assigning this whatever user I am viewing, whatever user I am getting from the database, I am adding that user in the entity model. Okay. Then, now I got the user. Now I want to construct the link to view all the user. How to construct the link? This is a get all user, right? This is a endpoint. I want to construct this endpoint here. How to do that? Web MVC builder is a method. Sorry, it's a class. Using that class, we can generate the any link that we want. Okay. Here is a one static method called link to. Link to. Inside that, we have to pass another static method called method on. Okay. The method on should. Method on is having an argument called, we need to pass a current class. We need to pass a current. What is the current class? My current class is a user controller. That is a this dot class. This dot class, from this class, I am calling a one method called get all user. I mean get all user. Whenever you call this get all user, what you will do is it will generate the endpoint for this particular method. Generate the endpoint for this particular method and assign to link to object. Okay, link to object. Now I have generated the endpoint link. Here I have generated the endpoint link. Now I want to give the link name. I want to give a link name. That we can do like this. Resource.r, my entity model. Resource nothing but the entity model. Resource.add, that is using add method, I am adding this link. I am adding this link. While adding that link, I am giving the name to that link called all users. Any name you can give. View all users. Okay. I think you hope you understand. When you view the response, you'll understand more clearly. Okay. Let's run the program now. Okay, application started. My H2 console. These are my H2 console. See, whenever you start the server, our H2 database get vanished, right? That you know already. I hope you know already. Whenever start the Spring Boot application, the H2 database, whenever shut down the Spring Boot application, whatever data available in the H2 database, those data get vanished, destroyed. Okay, whenever start the application, it will start freshly. This is my H2 console database. These are my H2 console DB. Okay. Now I want to access this particular H2 console. H2 console 8080. Localhost. Sorry, 8080 / H2 console. Okay. Why is not coming? Spelling mistakes. See the database matching here. Whatever database here, we need to use the database only here. Some version of Spring Boot application, it will generate the database name generate dynamically. Which time the database name will change? Okay, that time you need to use that particular database name here. Okay, otherwise it will not connect. This is the one hint I am saying. Someone can use different version of Spring Boot. In such a situation, each time when start the application, it will show the what is the current H2 database. Okay, just copy that and paste it here and connect. I am connecting now. user run. See, already I have a three rows of user. How come these three rows is coming here? Earlier I mentioned whenever start the Spring Boot application, you don't have any data in your guest database, right? But how come these three rows is coming here? That is because of in the project SRC main resource, there is a one SQL file I created, data.sql. Inside a data.sql, I have inserted, I have a three insert statement. Three insert statement, suresh.sykishore, maradhan.gmail, likishore.gmail, right? Three resource, three insert statement. Whenever start the Spring Boot application, your Spring Boot application check if there is any SQL file, that take that SQL file and insert the data automatically in your H2 database. That is the reason after starting the database, after starting the Spring Boot, I can see the data here. Otherwise, data will not be there. Okay. Now I have these three data. Now I want to view one user. While viewing the one user, I want to bring them, I want to generate the one more link that will return all the user. Okay. What is the endpoint for that? This is the endpoint. Okay, server is already started now. Okay, now I'm going to see this, show this demo in Postman. Username 21 is not found, right? So we need to check the proper username. Let's see. Is that? Okay. There are three users. Now I want to view the second user. Now I am getting the second user information. Along with this information, I want to generate the link for to view all the users. For that, I implemented the different endpoint, right? That is user hetios. We need to say user hetios /2. See this response now. I am viewing the user ID. Along with this user ID, there is a one more section, link section. In the link section, there is a view all users. In that view all users, there is a endpoint URL constructed automatically. This endpoint for viewing all the users in the database, right? See, it's giving all the user now. Okay. This is one beautiful feature in Spring Boot. Okay, we don't have to write manually to generate the links. Using Hetios framework, whatever resource you want to view, part of your current response, whatever response you are getting. For example, in our case, we are getting a user response, right? For part of the user response, I want to generate the one more link view all user that I am generating here using Hetios framework. Like that, you can do based on your project requirement. Okay, this is the purpose of Hetios. Okay, then yeah, that's it. Next video, we'll go to see some concept Richardson maturity model. Okay. I am going to post Richardson maturity model. This is the only concept. It does not have any programming, but you should know that. It will be very useful in interviews. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh Keshavan. If you like the video, please share this video to your friends and colleagues. Okay. Bye bye.